Okay, pause. Pause. Hey guys, I'm James Ruddle, and today's lesson is on shutter speed. Hey, Link, can you help me?
Yeah.
Say, hi.
Hi.
So today, Lincoln and I are gonna show you what shutter speed is with having a sword fight.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you ever wondered what shutter speed is? Well, in today's lesson, I'm gonna teach you all about it, but let's review from lesson one. If I wanna change my shutter speed, just use the dial and just go all the way to one side. 1/4000 is a very short amount of time. Here's 1 second. That's a very long time to take a photo. So it takes a whole second to take a photo. And what's happening is there's a lot of light there. I'm gonna take some photos of Lincoln with a slow shutter speed, so like a long shutter speed, and then a fast shutter speed, and we'll look at the difference. Okay, now do the same thing. Okay, move back, and I want you to go like this. Hi-ya!
Okay. Hi!
Oh my god, look at the photo. You look so amazing. Okay, this way.
Turn it on?
I'm just trying to zoom in. Okay, just 1 sec. So you still need to use the exposure compensation scale when changing your shutter speed. And if you're changing your shutter speed, you probably have to change your aperture as well. And so as Lincoln was swinging his sword around, I was just changing my aperture, my shutter speed, and my ISO all at the same time. But you'll notice that shutter speed affects not only the amount of light coming in, but also it affects how blurry the image is. So I just found this really, really cool spot at a creek, and there's flowing water, and I'm gonna show you the difference that shutter speed makes. So I'm gonna put my settings at ISO 100, and I'm gonna shoot right now at a fast shutter speed and then a slow shutter speed. So right now I just took a shot, F22, with 1/6 seconds, so a fairly long time, and you'll see that the water is silky smooth on the creek. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shoot with F7.1, so still sharp, but we'll see how crisp I can get the water. So the amazing thing about using a tripod is you can have a very long shutter, like 1 second or, you know, 1/5 of a second, and still you get no blur other than the blur of any movement that's happening. So I'm gonna get my kids sort of running on the field and show you the difference between the two things now that I've got a tripod as well. Can you jump up in the air? Shark! Can you just run back and then we're gonna go home? wow. Whoa, worms.
And mine is a girl.
Yours is a girl.
Know.
Link, what do you have?
I have a worm too.
So right there, I'm just playing with the difference between a long shutter speed and a slow shutter speed. And as you can see, there's a huge difference. The longer the shutter speed, the more blur is in any of the movements of the little kids as they're playing with the worm. Whereas when you've got a fast shutter speed and a lower aperture, your sharpness is there. So think about when you're using shutter speed, always be conscious of the amount of movement, especially with kids. Kids are always moving, so you want to make sure if you have a lot of movement, you're going to be shooting 1 over 250 or more or faster. So like 1 over 250 or 1 over 4,000. It just helps so much as the kids are moving to make sure that you get sharp focus on all of the limbs and in areas that the kids might be moving in. So today we had a long day of filming and shooting, but I hope that you learned about shutter speed today. Shutter speed affects the amount of light coming into the camera, but also any blur that might occur with any movement. I hope you enjoyed. Stay tuned for the next episode, which will teach you all about aperture and how and what it does. Thanks for watching.